So this what you see right now is the throne of Shivaji Maharaj. If you take a look closely, this is the replica of the throne which used to be there. The throne, actual throne, was in gold, around 6,700 kgs of gold and precious jewels were used. This right now we are not allowed to go over there because some incident happened before. This area which you see over there, this is where the coronation actually took place. That is the Mahadarwaza. We'll take a closer look at it later on. Now, all these steel pipes which you see over here, because every year the coronation happens on 6th of June on this fort, because that is the date when the coronation took place. So every year it happens, and right now I'm visiting, it's just around 24 days that has happened. So it is a very huge incidence, because of which all the stands and everything is used at that time, and it is not yet cleared up. That is why this area is filled with it. But this entire area is the Darbar of Shivaji Maharaj. This is where the coronation happened. This is where all the assemblies with the people used to take place. Now, as you can see, again the clouds are actually dominating the area. Now this is a huge area. This is the side from which we entered. The palace of Shivaji Maharaj and the Queen's palace is on the back side. Even the secretariat office, which we showed, is on the back side. This again, there is a little base which is over here, suggesting there might be another complex at this, in this area. This is an entirely huge area, and this is where the throne resides, just behind this. Due to the cloud cover, it is becoming difficult to actually show you everything. Nevertheless, this is the place where the history was made by Chatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, and the first Hindu king, first crowned Hindu king in 400 years. It's a very big deal. And the story of coronation is also very interesting, because last time when a Hindu king tried to coronate himself, it was in the Vijayanagara Empire. The Mughals, Adil Shah and Qutub Shah, all of them got together and destroyed the kingdom. And later on it was annexed by Adil Shah and Qutub Shah. But this similar thing should not happen. For this, Shivaji Maharaj had spread his detectives everywhere. They were spread across the country to tell him what is the situation. Now, Shivaji Maharaj was a very clever administrator, as I told you. So when he did that, the coronation date, as I said, 6th June 1674, it was not decided straight away, because it was difficult to know the pinpoint date because of what will happen if he did the coronation and his entire kingdom was at stake. So in around February, in April, he came to know that Aurangzeb is going to Afghanistan in order to break a revolt which has taken place over there, and no one in his kingdom was able to break the revolt. So he himself, the Mughal emperor himself, was going to Afghanistan, and Shivaji Maharaj had the son of Nizam with him at another fort. So what news he spread during that time is he's coronating the Nizam as the next Nizam, and that is why the Nizam of Hyderabad will not attack Shivaji Maharaj. He made sure that, because saying that he's coronating him actually changed the course. And as soon as he came to know that Aurangzeb is not in the empire now, he decided that within 2 months he should be coronated, and the date was set at 6th June 1674. Everything happened very quickly. All the arrangements were done, and on 6th June, this is a historic date, India saw the coronation of one of the greatest kings. And it is said that around 2 crore hones was the coins, golden coins during that era, was spent on this coronation, and it is in that time's money. So it is huge amount of money was spent for the coronation, And it is a very big deal because and majorly the big thing is Shivaji Maharaj is one of the very few kings who was accepted king first by the people, and then he was coronated, because Shivaji Maharaj started ruling since the age of 16, and the coronation happened in 1674 when he was 44 years of age. He had his kingdom for so many years, and the coronation happened very late, and people wanted it to happen, and so it happened. Right now I'm at a elevated level from where you can see the throne. As I told you, it is a little bit cloudy over here, so it is not visible clearly. This is the Mahadarwaza, or the entrance to the Darbar. Now I'm actually wondering how to go down. Okay, fine, I found a place. Now this is one structure which has been there since Shivaji Maharaj. It is standing tall because its construction would have been sturdy. All the structures of the fort which were made by wood or not so strong materials have been already destroyed. But this is one massive gate, a massive entrance to Chatrapati Shivaji Maharaj's Darbar, which is known as Nagarkhana. It is the name of the door, and as you can see the throne right there. Right there through the center we can see the throne of Chatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. It is said that it is constructed in a way that if you stand in the door there and whisper something in very soft voice, we can hear it on the throne. It is some incredible architecture which has taken place. So I would actually ask you that you visit this fort and experience it yourself. It is mind-blowing. There is no way we can know how this has happened, but it had happened. The architecture is, again, as you can see, Mughal architecture. It was pretty much inspired by that. When you take a close-up over there, we can see two lions and little elephants which are there below. The two flower decoration which is there, and on the top, as you can see, these kind of designs are there, and all kind of pillars and gates which are there in this fort, which I'd already shown you. So everything looks great still. The time has shown its power once again, because this being a 400 year old fort, you can't just keep everything the way it was. But it is still amazing and mesmerizing to see such a majestic structure standing tall. And what you see right now is kind of resemblance of how you see the Taj Mahal when you enter through the gate of Taj Mahal. Now, granted, the structure on that side is not that big, but it still looks amazing. And this is only, I guess, 10% of the fort. The entire fort is huge. I would like to show you the map of the fort. As you can see, this is the map. This is where you see the fort has 45 points. Now it is very difficult to actually see all of them. Right now where we are is at point number 20. If you can see the point number 20, that is where we are right now. That is why I said it's only 10%, because the entire fort is there on the right side, and we will go till point number 33. We will also try to go to 34 and 35 if we can, and we'll see this next. So I'll start recording when I'll reach those points, and if I see anything important, I'll tell you about it. So yeah, the next recording will start from the bazaar area which was there.